A1C is not an acronym, but stands for glycated hemoglobin. Glycation is a technical way of saying how a sugar molecule binds to a protein. Hemoglobin is the protein in red blood cells that transports oxygen in the body. Some circulating glucose in the bloodstream attaches to the hemoglobin in red blood cells. When hemoglobin is bound to glucose, it's called hemoglobin A1C. This is what is measured by your healthcare provider. The higher the level of glucose in the blood, the more hemoglobin gets bound by glucose. The basic concept is that your blood glucose combines with hemoglobin in your red blood cells to form A1C. Once the glucose binds to the hemoglobin, it remains combined for the lifespan of the red blood cell, which is about 120 days. Your A1C measure is obtained from your blood. Your blood is taken from a vein in your arm using a needle, or your finger is pricked using a lancet. The test can be taken anytime during the day by your healthcare provider, and you can eat or drink normally before the test. What do the results indicate? A1C is expressed as a percentage of hemoglobin that is bound by glucose. It measures your average blood glucose levels for the past 2 to 3 months, since red blood cells have a lifespan of 120 days, as mentioned before. Think of A1C as a batting average, which measures a batter's average performance. In this case, the A1C test is measuring your average blood glucose levels to see how well your diabetes is being managed. According to the American Diabetes Association, an A1C percentage of 6.5% or higher indicates diabetes. 5.7 to 6.4% indicates prediabetes. Normal levels are below 5.7%. A common treatment goal for diabetes is less than 7%, but your healthcare provider will provide an appropriate goal for you. This chart displays how the A1C percentage corresponds to an estimated average blood glucose level. It is important to remember that A1C levels do not compare with daily blood glucose levels because A1C is an average. As you can see, a lower A1C percentage indicates better average glucose control. Small changes in your A1C percentage equal big changes in your blood glucose levels. As A1C increases, the risk of complications increase. Some of these complications include heart attacks, strokes, kidney failure, vision problems, and numbness in your legs and feet. This test is usually completed when an individual has risk factors for diabetes. These risk factors include increasing age, family history of diabetes, being overweight, having an unhealthy diet, high blood pressure, and high lipid levels, or when symptoms of diabetes are shown, such as increased thirst, frequent urination, hunger, and fatigue. It is also used for monitoring purposes after being diagnosed with diabetes. For those with diabetes, the test is usually conducted 2 times a year by a healthcare provider. If your blood glucose levels are stable, your healthcare provider might conduct the test 4 times a year if your treatment goal is not met or if there is a change in your treatment plan. There are some conditions that will give a false A1C reading, so the test would not be useful for the following conditions. If you experience heavy or chronic bleeding, your hemoglobin stores may be depleted. This may make your A1C test results appear low. If you have iron deficiency anemia, which is when blood lacks an adequate amount of red blood cells, your A1C test results may appear high. If you had a recent blood transfusion or hemolytic anemia, red blood cells are destroyed before their intended lifespan. The results may appear low. A1C helps in the diagnosis of prediabetes or diabetes. Instead of a single blood glucose reading, A1C reflects long-term blood glucose control. Think of your daily blood glucose readings as a snapshot and your A1C level as a hidden camera that monitors your blood glucose 24 hours, 7 days a week. When you have your A1C tested, it tells you what your average blood glucose level was for the past 2 to 3 months prior to the test. When compared to single blood glucose readings, A1C is a better reflection of how well your diabetes treatment plan is working overall, since blood glucose levels change during the day due to medication, diet, exercise, and the level of insulin in your blood. It can also help determine if diet education is needed or if your insulin or medication regimen needs to be adjusted. It provides feedback to help control your glucose levels. It is important to keep in mind that the A1C test does not replace regular glucose monitoring. Overall, A1C is an important measure for diabetic individuals to understand. Let's review. A1C is a measure of the amount of hemoglobin and glucose that are bound together. It is obtained by a blood test. Results are interpreted as a percentage, in which a lower A1C percentage is usually better. The test is usually conducted 2 or 4 times a year. Individuals with heavy bleeding, anemia, or blood transfusions will have unreliable results due to the nature of these conditions. The importance of the A1C measure is that it provides feedback on how well you are managing your diabetes and determines if the current treatment plan is effective. Now that you have the understanding of A1C, you will be able to use this information to discuss your A1C level with your healthcare provider. Thank you for your time, and I hope this information was helpful. This video was produced by Lauren Wozniak with Penn State Extension in collaboration with Raina Cooper. References for this material are listed on the following slides.